call me the Yoda guy because of photos of me assembling the original Yoda that was radio controlled, that was in Luke's backpack when he was doing somersaults on Dagobah. I was actually part of a team that built the creatures for the principal photography. You can see some of us up here now with the creatures from the Mos Eisley Cantina. We built Chewbacca, we built the Wampa, we built the Tauntaun and the Minuc and the Ugnaughts. We did life casts to put Han Solo in carbonite. We have that in my little museum here in St. Martin. Here we're trying to encourage young people to follow their dreams and be all they can be. And we have a foundation here, which is called the Yoda Guy Movie Museum. And also in Europe, which is called the Follow Your Star Foundation. And really, we have different projects to try to reach out to young people. One of those is a new project called Saving Yoda. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to build a new Yoda for the new anthology movies. Lucasfilm had built a physical puppet for episode one, which was very unpopular. And so it's very unlikely that they will want to make the same mistake twice. So what we're doing is trying to persuade them that it is the right way to go, rather than going for CG, which doesn't have the heart and soul that Frank Oz, the original puppeteer, was able to put into Yoda. So you can see photos here of me while I was sculpting a new Yoda. And we're in the process of making that now. And we're going to be raising money for that particular project through a website called savingyoda.com. I'm in contact with a number of the people who are working on the project.
Okay.
But when you're making a movie, mm-hmm. it's very stressful. Heads of department have nervous breakdowns. People have meltdowns. People don't stay on time or on budget. And there's a lot of money that's involved. Because there's so much money involved, they don't really want to take the risk. So once you're working in the studio and you're doing a good job, when a new movie moves into that studio, mm-hmm. you're very likely to be the one that gets that work. So I'm sitting in the Caribbean drinking pina coladas, and to be quite honest, it's hard for some people to understand, but I don't want to abandon my wife for the next 5 years while we make the next five movies.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very happy, more than happy, to work on a new Yoda. I can go away and we can film for 3 months and then I can be back here in the Caribbean. Who would want to leave the Caribbean anyway,
no
right?
One.
Exactly. But I really don't want to be the guy who's responsible. And they have a great team that's working on these new movies.
Okay.
They're doing good work. I'm going to be flying into Puerto Rico on December the 16th. And I'm going to be doing guest of honor at a number of different events that are taking place at Caribbean cinemas. And you have a 4G cinema in Puerto mm-hmm. Rico as well. I'm going to be there for their opening too. So, and of course, I've got a lot of friends and fans in Puerto Rico, all those costumed guys that you're going to see around the opening at the 501st and other things. I'm a member of the Mandalorian Mercs in Puerto Rico. They made me an honorary member. I always feel at home in Puerto Rico because the fans there have been so warm and so encouraging. I really look forward to going there.
Thank you.
If you want to link to the video that you were watching, you go to savingyoda.com. SavingYoda.com.
For my ally is the Force, and a powerful ally it is. Life creates it, makes it grow. Its energy surrounds us and binds us.